The Institute of Education Sciences is the research, evaluation, and statistics arm of the U.S. Department of Education. IES supports research that addresses important issues in education and develops solutions that improve school readiness and education outcomes for all students.
Preschools benefit from University of Nebraska Lincoln research on effective ways to get kids ready to learn. Children who don't develop important language, cognitive, and behavioral skills have a tough time once they start school.
When a child enters a learning environment and doesn't have those kinds of abilities, they start off well behind their peers, they start off well behind the eight ball. And it's very challenging, we know, for a child to catch up.
University of Nebraska Lincoln researchers work with parents and teachers to help children develop the skills they need to succeed in school. The Getting Ready intervention encourages parents to get involved.
The parents are the child's first teacher, so being involved with them, we can really work together and work on their strengths as well as their weaknesses.
And the more that the parents and teachers can work together as partners and collaborate around creating learning goals and establishing these kinds of experiences for children, the better it is for children.
An initial study funded by the National Institutes of Health found that when parents were involved, children improved in areas such as language development and early literacy.
Children who were involved in the program and whose parents and teachers were actively engaged as partners fared much better relative to those who were not involved.
Researchers will track children and families through kindergarten to evaluate the long-term benefits of the program.
The Getting Ready intervention is a parent engagement intervention that's focused specifically on helping young children with disabilities and children at risk for developing disabilities start off on the right foot as they enter school. It's comprised of eight strategies that collectively focus on helping parents engage more actively and meaningfully in their children's learning by forming partnerships and relationships with significant people in the child's life. So the strategies together that build relationships and strengthen partnerships between parents and educators and between parents and their children can be used in unstructured situations, such as when a parent drops their child off at school in the morning or when a parent might pick their child up from a center in the afternoon. But it's also very important as a tool by which parents and their young children's educators can work collaboratively in more structured situations, such as home visits or in traditional parent-teacher conferences. We've learned a number of things about this intervention and what's important to make it work. The first take-home message is that relationships matter. Relationships are very important in helping a child be successful and achieve the outcomes early on in their life and throughout their educational careers. We have also learned that we cannot do it alone. So the partnerships that we establish with all of the other significant adults in a child's life become really salient, not only in terms of impacting an immediate effect that we see as we intervene around particular goals for children with disabilities, but also sustaining those effects over time. Another important message that we're finding is the importance of early childhood coaching. The job of educating a young child with disabilities can be very challenging. Our coaching efforts are intentional, structured, very focused coaching opportunities where we can help an educator learn the best way to really partner with families is something that can be generalized then to all situations where they're working with families. One of the things that's very exciting is a colleague at the University of Nebraska, Dr. Lisa Kanoki, has extended this work downward into an infant toddler population and is working with infants and toddlers with disabilities and also who are at risk for developing disabilities and focus specifically on center-based programs and how we can really modify the way that we're engaging families in those settings. Another opportunity for growth in this area is continuing to look at the longer term effects of the Getting Ready intervention for children with disabilities as they transition into more traditional school programs. A very exciting opportunity that we're pursuing now with some no-cost extension work supported by IES is dissemination and scale-up. When I say dissemination, what I mean by that is reaching out to practitioners and policymakers and making sure that they have information in their hands that they need to make decisions about practices in their own agencies, in their own school settings, and within their own policy domains. Finally, we are manualizing the intervention. We are putting all of our training materials into modules for the people that are really interested in engaging with families in meaningful ways. They have the resources available to them.
The Institute of Education Sciences' priority is research that contributes to improved education outcomes for all students. We fund research on new, practical, and innovative approaches that can help teachers and students successfully meet 21st century challenges.